Mr. Tesla?
As an officer of the court, I would say that that will be enough to prove beyond a reasonable doubt by a reasonable jury in the state of Nevada.
All right. Mr. Mack, you understand that as to the specific intent element of the plea, the facts that Mr. Daskus refers to and the facts that were garnered through the first week and a half of testimony, those are the facts that I'll rely upon for the record in accepting the plea. I know you're not acknowledging the specific intent element, but do you understand that I'll rely upon all those things and the transcripts of the previous testimony will be essentially attached, if you will, in support of the intent element of the crime?
So let me understand. So that's what you're going to be attaching, that to support the intent element?
There has to be a factual basis to support a plea. Sometimes the plea is guilty, which is what you entered and accepted responsibility for in count one. Sometimes individuals plead Alford, at which point the state makes a statement of what factually would be sufficient to support the plea, even though the accused is pleading by way of Alford. Excuse me. So in this case, I know you're accepting responsibility for shooting Judge Weller, but the intent element, I'll accept the statement of facts from the state as well as the testimony that's already been had and the proffered rebuttal witness, just in terms of finding a factual basis to enter the plea on the record. Not asking you
to enter the Alford plea.
Yes. Okay. You understand that?
I believe I understand.
And I think it'll help Mr. Mack understand that that's a legal requirement in order for the benefits of the plea negotiations to be afforded him, but there's question based on his Alford plea, not only for the benefit of the plea, but also relate to his mental state at the time, which has always been an issue.
And understand that?
I do.
Okay. And it's my understanding as well that in terms of an Alford plea, you've made a determination in consultation with your attorneys that it's in your best interest to enter the plea at this time?
Yes.
And that part of the reasons you're deciding to enter the pleas at this time is to avoid the harsher or the possibility of harsher penalties were you to proceed on through trial and be convicted of the original charges. I'm not saying that's the primary reason or all of the reason, but is that part of the consideration for entering the Alford plea at this time is to avoid any possible harsher penalties were you to be convicted at trial of the original charges?
That would be one of the reasons.
All right. All right. So again, I'll ask you, do you have any questions for me or your attorneys before I formally accept your pleas?
One thing I wanted to just tell the court is that I do understand in my right now state of mind that shooting at the judiciary is not the proper form of political redress. And also, I want one other thing I'd like to tell you is I would also like to let you know that through the process, it has been a privilege to watch due process in action, and I really appreciate Your Honor's integrity in performing a very high integrity judicial process. It's been, even though I have much at stake, it's been a pleasure to have somebody who really takes their job seriously.
All right. Thank you. All right. Anything further from the state?
No, Your Honor.
Anything further from the defense?
No, Your Honor.
Also thank the prosecutors for their professionalism and everybody in your courtroom and yourself, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going to go ahead and find that the defendant's plea is freely and voluntarily made and he understands the nature and consequences of the offense and of his plea, and therefore I'll accept his pleas of guilty in Alford. I'm going to go ahead and refer the matter to the Department of Parole and Probation for the preparation of a pre-sentence investigation report, talk to the attorneys, and we're going to set this for a sentencing hearing on January the 17th and 18th of 2008. It's my understanding in consultation with the attorneys that you all are going to stipulate and would request that the hearing be held here. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, that's the understanding, Your Honor.
All right. We will go ahead and order that. It's also my understanding that the defense wishes in consideration at least of the fact that, Mr. Freeman, you'll be up in Reno and want to be able to consult with Mr. Mack over the next couple of months, that Mr. Mack be returned to Washoe County pending sentencing. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. I will go ahead and order that. It's also my understanding that you would like Mr. Mack to be brought down here, or be brought back down here, I should say, the Friday before the Thursday-Friday sentencing hearing, correct?
That's correct. Thank you.
All right. Which would be the 11th of January, I think. Is that should be Friday. It's January the 11th. Okay. So I'll ask the state to prepare a transport order to have Mr. Mack brought back down to Clark County on Friday, January the 11th.
We will do that, Your Honor.
All right. Thank you very much. The hearing will start on the 17th at 10 a.m. and roll over into the 18th as needed, starting again at 10 a.m. And I'll ask counsel to kind of get together over the next couple of months as we get closer to that date, and if your presentation of evidence related to sentencing you think is doesn't need both days, let me know, and we'll just do it all on the Friday. But I'll go ahead and leave the Thursday and Friday open to make sure that everybody's got ample time to present whatever issues they want to present to the court for sentencing.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, folks. I will tell you that I will give you reciprocity in your thanks to me. I know that the issues related to some resolution of this case have been discussed among you for a long time, and I think your professionalism and respect of each other is a large reason you get to the point you get at this point in town, or at this point in time. So I thank you for your work, and I will see you in a couple months.
Thank you.
All right, gentlemen. Take care. Mr. Lally, don't you point it out? Yeah, actually, you approach the bench real quick.